Hello guys, and welcome back to another video from Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. In the last videos, we have talked about bryophytes. But in this video, we are going to proceed our discussion on plant kingdom and we are going to talk about pteridophyte. So, if we are going to talk comparatively, then we can easily understand the things very, very carefully. In bryophytes, we talked about liverworts and mosses. But in case of pteridophytes, there are ferns and horsetails. Right? जैसे bryophytes में क्या थे? Liverworts और mosses थे, उसी तरीके से pteridophytes में horsetails और ferns आ जाएंगे. ये सबसे important चीज है. After that, if we will talk about the body organization, then we know very well that the bryophytes are thalloid, that they are lacking true root stems and leaves, but they may possess root-like, stem-like and leaf-like structures. उनमें true root, stem, leaves नहीं थे, लेकिन अगर हम बात करें pteridophytes की, so the main plant body is going to be sporophytic, which is also a difference. Bryophytes में it is gametophytic, but in case of pteridophytes, the main plant body is sporophytic and it do have true root, stems and leaves. Okay, it means that the main plant body is not thalloid. क्योंकि अब यहाँ पर true root stem leaves आ चुके हैं, तो main plant body जो है thalloid नहीं होगी, कुछ stages thalloid हो सकती हैं, जैसे कि prothallus, उसके बारे में हम पढ़ेंगे इसी lecture में. So the main differences are very very clear, right? These are containing horsetail and ferns. The second thing is their main plant body is sporophytic, जो कि gametophytic थी in case of bryophytes. And the third thing that they do have true root stems and leaves. After that, they are the first one जिनमें vascular tissues present थे. There are no vascular tissues in algae, there are no vascular tissues in bryophytes, but there are vascular tissues in case of pteridophytes. What are vascular tissues? Xylem and phloem. Xylem is for the transportation of water and phloem is for the transportation of food, or we can say sugars, right? So xylem और phloem जो थे वो present थे pteridophytes में. सबसे पहले इन्हीं में आए थे. These are the first terrestrial plants in which the true vascular tissues are found. Okay? These are the major differences. When we talk about habitat कि ये कहाँ पर पाए जाएंगे, then cool, damp, moist, shady places, just similar to that of bryophytes, but they can also flourish well in sandy soil conditions. So ये cool, damp, shady places पे तो पाए ही जाएंगे, लेकिन ये sandy soils में भी गुजारा कर सकते हैं. Right? So they are typically terrestrial. ये mostly क्या होते हैं? Terrestrial plants होते हैं. Because they do have vascular tissue, so now they can absorb the nutrients from ground. Okay? And they can transport them well to all the different parts of their plant's body. So अब इनको water में रहने की कोई ज़्यादा ज़रूरत नहीं है. हालांकि in some of the stages, they do depend on water for fertilization and different kind of reproductive events. Therefore, they are present in cool, damp and shady places, right? थोड़ा बहुत water तो इनको भी चाहिए ही अपनी सारी reproductive activities को complete करने के लिए. After that, there are different kind of uses of pteridophytes. They can be medicinal, okay? They can be used for making different kind of medicines. They can be ornamental. कुछ flowers बहुत ज़्यादा सुंदर होते हैं, तो उनको इसलिए घर में उगाया जाता है जिससे कि वो attractive लगे, right? And there are different kind of other purpose too. कई प्लांट्स ऐसे होते हैं जिनकी बेले बहुत सुंदर होती हैं, सो उसके लिए उन्हें घर में लगाया जाता है. देयर आर डिफरेंट पर्पसेस. आफ्टर दैट, दे आर वेरी गुड सॉइल बाइंडर्स. वी हैव ऑलरेडी टेकन दिस पॉइंट इन ब्रायोफाइट्स दैट दे यूज्ड टू बाइंड द सॉइल टू प्रिवेंट द सॉइल इरोजन, राइट? सो दे आर ऑल्सो वेरी गुड सॉइल बाइंडर्स. तो ब्रायोफाइट्स और टेरिडोफाइट्स में ये पॉइंट काफी कॉमन हो जाते हैं. जो मेन डिफरेंसेस है वो उनकी स्ट्रक्चरल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में है. Since this particular plant is having true root stems and leaves, so it becomes very important to discuss them. So there are two different kind of leaves which may be present. There can be microphylls, right? Phylls simply means leaves. So micro means small leaves which are present in Selaginella. So in Selaginella, very small leaves are present. Lekin ferns jo hote hain, right? Which is the second category of pteridophytes. हमने बात की horsetails or ferns. So that fern is having very large and broad leaves. So obviously if the size is large, it is known as the macrophylls. Okay? तो मैक्रो का एग्जांपल हुआ फर्न्स और माइक्रोफिश का एग्जांपल हुआ सेलाजिनेला, राइट। आफ्टर दैट द स्पोरोफाइट, वी नो वेरी वेल दैट द मेन प्लांट बॉडी इज नाउ स्पोरोफिटिक, इन केस ऑफ ब्रायोफाइट इट इज गैमेटोफिटिक, लेकिन यहां पर मेन प्लांट बॉडी अगर स्पोरोफिटिक है सो इट विल बी कंटेनिंग अ स्पोरेंजिया, और स्पोरेंजिया हम पढ़ चुके हैं कि व्हाट इज स्पोरेंजिया, स्पोरेंजिया यूज्ड टू कंटेन द स्पोर्स विच आर फॉर्म्ड आफ्टर मियोसिस और रिडक्शनल डिवीजन, सो द स्पोरेंजिया विल बी फॉर्मिंग स्पोर्स आफ्टर मियोसिस, दैट्स फॉर श्योर, बट द स्पोरेंजिया इज सबटेंडेड बाय लीफ लाइक स्ट्रक्चर, कुछ लीफ लाइक स्ट्रक्चर होते हैं जो कि स्पोरेंजिया के पास प्रेजेंट होते हैं, दिस इज द स्पोरेंजिया, लेट्स सपोज देयर आर सम स्ट्रक्चर्स लाइक दैट, okay, that are known as sporophylls. Now these are leaf-like structure and we have already talked about the word phyll that is used for leaves. So if it is present near the sporangium, it is known as sporophyll. So sporophyte mein kya hoga? Sporophyte mein ek sporangia hoga and that sporangia is enclosed by some leaf-like structures which are known as sporophylls, right? In some cases, the sporophylls become much compact. And that compact structure is known as strobili or cone. Okay? So, cone ban jata hai wo ek. Is tarike ka compact structure ban jata hai. Because in those cases, the sporophylls are very, very compact. So, it forms strobili or strobilus and cone. For example, equisetum and selaginella. So, in selaginella and equisetum, the subtended leaves, okay, or we can call them what, sporophyll will become much compact and that compact structure surrounding the sporangia will form the strobili or the cone, right? And the examples are equisetum and selaginella and yahan se question aata hai. So this is the most important question from this particular article. After that we know very well that there is sporangia which will contain spore and the spore are formed after the meiosis process or the reductional division because the number of chromosomes used to become half in that particular case kyunki wo spore fir aage germinate hokar kya banayega gametophyte which is haploid stage so diploid se agar haploid hame banana hai for that we need reductional division that's why meiosis is taking place over here that spore will be germinating and obviously it is forming gametophyte right but what are the structure of that gametophyte that these are going to be thalloid okay थैलॉइड गैमेटोफाइट बनेगा एक बहुत ही छोटा होगा इनकॉन्स्पिक्यूअस इट मींस दैट उसको हम अच्छे से आइडेंटिफाई नहीं कर पाएंगे ओके इट इज वेरी स्मॉल इनकॉन्स्पिक्यूअस वी कैन नॉट आइडेंटिफाई दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग प्रॉपरली वी कैन नॉट डिफरेंशिएट इट बट इट इज मल्टीसेलुलर ओके सो इट इज स्मॉल इनकॉन्स्पिक्यूअस बट मल्टीसेलुलर इन ओरिजिन आफ्टर दैट दिस थैलस लाइक स्ट्रक्चर ओके सिंस इट इज थैलॉइड गैमेटोफाइट So that thallus-like structure is known as prothallus. This word is very important. Now another different thing which is very important for this lecture is this prothallus. ये कैसा होगा? It is free living. In case of bryophyte, we have talked that the sporophyte that is formed depends on the gametophyte for its nutrition. So the sporophyte is not independent. But in this case, this gametophyte is photosynthetic and it is going to be independent. This is the major difference, right? So this is the first part of this video in which we have just talked about the general introduction of pteridophytes. In the next lecture, we will be talking about the reproductive properties, but let's revise this lecture first and let me tell you the most important points jahan se question banenge. So the very first thing is their habitat, moist, shady, cool, damp places, and they can flourish well on sandy soils also. After that, they are the first one to possess vascular tissues, that is xylem and phloem. After that, they are used in different kind of things such as medicinal purposes, they can be ornamental and they are obviously the soil binders just like bryophytes. Okay, वहाँ पर mosses भी soil को bind कर रहे थे. The main plant body which is haplontic or which is gametophytic in bryophyte is now sporophytic. Okay, so main plant body क्या होगी? Sporophytic होगी. Which will possess true root stem and leaf. Now there are two different type of leaves. The one is smaller size, that is microphylls, such as in selaginella, and in ferns it is macro. And the horsetails and ferns are the two different categories of pteridophyte itself. उसके बाद बात करते हैं थोड़ी से रिप्रोडक्शन की. सो द स्पोरोफाइट इज द मेन प्लांट बॉडी. इट विल बी हैविंग अ स्पोरेंजिया व्हिच इज सबटेंडेड बाय सम लीफ लाइक स्ट्रक्चर नोन एज स्पोरोफिल्स. जब वो स्पोरोफिल्स कॉम्पैक्ट हो जाएंगी दे विल फॉर्म अ कोन लाइक स्ट्रक्चर दैट इज ऑब्वियसली नोन एज कोन और स्ट्रोबिला. द स्पोरेंजिया विल कंटेन स्पोर्स व्हिच आर फॉर्मड आफ्टर मियोसिस और रिडक्शनल डिवीजन. दैट स्पोर विल बी जर्मिनेटिंग टू फॉर्म अ थैलॉइड स्ट्रक्चर नोन एज प्रोथैलस. ओके और उस प्रोथैलस की क्या प्रॉपर्टीज होंगी. इट इज स्मॉल, इट इज अनकॉन्स्पिक्यूअस एंड वो क्या होगा, मल्टीसेलुलर होगा. स्मॉल अनकॉन्स्पिक्यूअस तो होगा ही, मल्टीसेलुलर भी होगा एंड इट इज फ्री लिविंग. इट मींस दैट इट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द स्पोरोफाइट. बट इन केस ऑफ प्रायोफाइट जो स्पोरोफाइट था इट इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन द गैमेटोफाइट फॉर इट्स फूड. Right, but in this case it is totally dependent on its own. Right, it is independent. ये खुद ही अपना खाना बना सकता है. So there are some things due to which the distribution is limited of pteridophytes. For example, the thalloid gametophyte or the prothallus, it can live on land, right? But it requires water for fertilization. It means ये water body से ज़्यादा दूर नहीं जा सकते. Because they will be surely requiring water for the reproductive purposes or fertilization process. So they cannot go much to a much distance than a water body. So their geographical distribution is very less. काफी कम ही जगह होते हैं जहां पर ये सारी चीजें पाई जाती हैं, क्योंकि ये proper land पर भी नहीं पाए जा सकते. इन्हें water की कहीं ना कहीं जरूरत तो पड़ेगी. So water body से ज्यादा दूर ये नहीं जा सकते, right? So these examples of strobili cone, that is equisetum, selaginella, the micro and macrophylls, okay, the microphylls in selaginella and the macrophylls in ferns, and the prothallus and its properties. These are the most important questions from this particular lecture. In the next lecture, we are going to talk about the remaining things about pteridophytes, and after that, we will proceed towards gymnosperms and angiosperms. I hope you enjoyed the lecture very well. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. I am making a timetable for you for the preparation of NEET 2019 and a chapter wise schedule, so that what kind of chapters you can prepare in a single month and for next month and so on. So I'll be posting that timetable on Sunday, that is tomorrow. So stay tuned for that. Thank you so much and keep supporting.